Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Molly, and today I'm going to be telling you about 13 underrated Netflix shows that you probably haven't heard of in 2020. These shows are binge worthy. If you haven't checked out my part one, I will link it down below. I'll put it up here. I'll put it at the end, don't worry. That are my top picks. These are my second top picks. However, when I made the first one, some of these shows hadn't come out. So it's not really a comparison, but I would say part one, that's a good one. Shout out to the person, I'm gonna insert the comment right here, who suggested me make a part two. Thank you for your input. And if any of you guys want to suggest for me to make a video, I will make it. I say that in every video. If you want me to make a video, I will make it. So yeah, leave a comment down below what you want me to make. So I'm just gonna start off. These are in no particular order, but I'm just gonna start off right away. Hold on, I first have to say this. What I'm going to explain to you, and for all these shows, is like the first episode or two. So there might be plot twists later that I've already figured out, but if I say it now, you'll know. So I'm gonna explain the first episode or two to you guys, that way you can understand the main idea of the show without me spoiling it, okay? Alright, so the first show is Queen of the South, and it's about a dealer's girlfriend who her boyfriend dies and she gets kidnapped and forced to be like a mule, and she has no idea. She's used to living this luxurious life and now she's forced into like this terrible one, and so she decides to try to make alliances and make her way to the top, and this is introduced in the first one. It's how she becomes the next queen of the South. That's the name of the show. How she becomes the next queen of the house. How she makes her way up from being kidnapped to being the queen of all of that. So that's really cool. I really love the show. Definitely my go-to show right now. The next one, I have my list right here in case you're wondering why I'm looking dumb. The next one is The Order. This is another go-to show right now too. The Order is about this college that has a secret society that lets kids in to practice magic. And without magic, there's like a price. And the kids don't know that. And there's werewolves and there's vampires and there's all this stuff. And it's super fun. I love the show. There's a lot of mystery and they're trying to like solve dark magic, good magic, parallel universes, all that stuff. Love it. Definitely try it. Okay, the next one is something I love. I already finished it, but it was Selling Sunset. Selling Sunset is so good. I love it. It's about real estate agents in Hollywood, Los Angeles, and them trying to sell homes, multi-million dollar homes, and like the drama that comes with it and the relationships and the buyers, and you get to see the homes. You get to see like the little like cat fights between the girls. Sorry if I'm squinting. I have lights right there because it's a little dim outside right now. Try to open my eyes as much as I can. Okay, the next one is The Society. So I have not finished the show yet, and it is about these kids who are in a town and all the adults die or they're gone. So they know there's no adults and they can't get out of the town. They go, they try to leave the town, they just end up back on the other side. It's just like a never ending. We don't know why. I haven't figured out why. And they have to kind of make their own society. And it starts off like, oh, we'll do this. And then like, no, I don't want to do that. I don't want to do that. We'll do this. We'll do this. We'll do that. No, don't do that. And it's like, you know, how kids are. And they have to make their own society and all the drama and the death that can come with that of not having an actual government and governing yourself. So the next one is New Girl. So this I actually just started, like literally like a week ago, I think. And it's about this girl who moves in, the single girl who moves in with three bachelor guys. And she's like a teacher. She moves in with three bachelor guys who like are single too. And it's like them, like kind of like helping her like become a better like person and like, you know, like get with guys and like all that stuff. Like they help her. They're like, they turn into like her brothers kind of. I've only watched the first couple episodes, so, but for the rest of the shows I finished them, but like that one I really like so far. It's very, very interesting. Okay, so the next one is Cheer. So this is about the drama and the reality and the competitions of being on a college cheer team, and I think it's the number one college cheer team, I think. Don't quote me on that. But it's an actual documentary reality TV kind of cheer, and it's really interesting, and you end up voting for people. No, they should be flat. You learn a lot about cheer, so if you want to know more about cheer or be on college cheer, that's the thing for you. So the next one is Get Even. Okay, now I do have to say something about this. So I finished a show I did not try it for a while because I always scrolled past it and thought it looked stupid. I was like, oh, it's PG, it looks like a kid's show, it looks stupid, you know, like, I don't want to watch that, you know what I mean? But, however, I decided, you know what, it has an interesting concept, so let me try it. So I clicked on it and I watched it. So it's about this group of kids who decide to get even, pretty much take revenge on anyone who's wronged anyone else in the school and kind of make the playing field even, from teachers to students to staff, everything, to parents. But then it turns into a murder investigation, I'm not gonna tell you how, and it kind of just all spirals down. Their little thing that they call themselves DGM, don't get mad, get even, DGM, it just spirals because people are dying and, you know, they're just trying to cool it off. So I'd actually say it's a really good show. It's not cheesy. Just because that's something I've always made an assumption about, just because a show is PG does not mean it's not good. So I do have to say that. It was actually very good. So the next one is Queer Eyes, and this you've probably heard of. It's about five men. I don't exactly know. I'm pretty sure they're all part of the LGBTQ community, but I don't know exactly, so don't quote me on that. However, they go and they transform someone random's life. It doesn't matter, straight, whatever. It's literally just a random person's life. They transform from their style to their house to their relationships to their personality. Well, not like change their personality, but like the way they act and stuff like that, and they just change everything about them. So like, but like in a good way, not in like let's change you, like it's not like their personality, you know, like they change like them to make them become from someone who's like not dressing the best, not getting, you know, partner or whatever they want, to like someone who's like up here. And the transformations are really cool. You don't have to watch them in order, you can just like flip through, see whatever one looks interesting to you. So the next one is All American. You've probably heard of this one, however I love it. It's so good. It's so like heartwarming, and it's about this football player who is in like a low-end neighborhood in California, and he gets recruited to play in the Beverly Hills football team. And pretty much what happens there is, right, he went from somewhere low to like somewhere high, is that his friends in the lower thing are not accepting him anymore, saying, oh, you think you're so cool because you're part of that team. But then his friends in the higher one, oh, you're not cool, you were part of like in the lower class, you know what I mean? And so his friends and his other friends, and he also moves out like with his parents, like he doesn't move with his parents, he like stays, and I think it's the coach's house. I finished it like a while ago. I think it's the coach's house. He's living with them, and so it's like the drama of that. He's trying to be a good kid, but the coach's kid is like wild. So it's a really good show. Definitely recommend, but you've probably heard of that one, but still recommend it. Okay, so the next one is Working Moms. I don't think you've heard this one. You might have, I don't know, there's a lot of people on the internet, but no one I've talked to has heard of it. It's about four moms who go from the beginning of being pregnant to having the kid to dealing with the kid, being in the workforce, but it's like a comedy, so it's not like a drama, you know what I mean? It's a comedy of all four of them kind of getting through motherhood together, and it's really good. Okay. So the next one is Daybreak. This one I do like. I'd say I like it. It's not one of my top faves. However, if you're really into like the zombie stuff and stuff like that, it's really good. If you like zombie stuff. So it's not for everyone, but I liked it. Didn't love it, liked it though. And it's about this kid who post-apocalyptic, all the zombies, is trying to find his like true love, and he's adventuring with his friends all through the zombie thing, and he kind of makes it a joke. Like, he kind of makes the apocalypse a joke. Like, huh, you can't reach me from here, you little zombie. It's a lot of swearing and stuff, but like, it's funny. It's a funny comedy. It's not like drama, like dark and heavy, like some of the other zombie ones. It's like more of like he's making fun of the apocalypse, kind of like, I don't care if there's apocalypse, I'm gonna find my true love, you know what I mean? So the next one, and this one I'm pretty sure you've heard of, Umbrella Academy. So this is about this guy who takes in like these kids who are all born like just at the same time, but like not like born, like all the women got pregnant at the same time, like randomly, and not like they didn't do anything, they're pregnant, and he pretty much takes them in, they all have superpowers, and he trains them to like fight evil and like solve mysteries. So I don't want to get in too much, I don't want to spoil it, but it's really good. And then The last one is Lost in Space. I love this one. It's about a family who goes on a mission to like a new colony, and they end up getting lost in space, and they have to deal with aliens and surviving and like the weather and like the space, you know what I mean? Like all surviving at all, like alone with just each other. And there's other characters introduced and stuff, and it's a really good mystery, really good action show. Okay, so that was all the shows for this one, part two. However, if you did enjoy this one, I'd really like for you to check out part one, because those have even more, like, I'd have to say those have some of my top tier shows in them that you probably never have heard of. So these were really good. I love these shows, but I also want to recommend that one. Please leave me a comment down below of what idea you want me to do, and I will do it, and I'll give you a shout out. Alright? So don't worry. Be happy. I'd really like for you to like and subscribe. I'm trying to grow my channel. My goal is to get to 1,000 subscribers by December, and I'm halfway to being monetized, so thank you guys all for your support. If you're not a subscriber, thank you for watching, and please subscribe. If you are a subscriber, thank you so much for watching and keeping up with my videos. I really do appreciate it, all like 400 of you. I love you all. I've seen your channels. I've gone through your content. I know kind of what you're about, and I appreciate your support. And if you made it this far in the video and I'm still talking, I appreciate your full support for giving me that watch time, because I love making videos and I love to like grow bigger. So thank you guys so much for watching. Leave me a comment down below of what other kinds of videos you'd like me to do, and I will do it. Remember, I upload every Sunday at 5, and thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe.